So I have received tons of questions about how I would write a story using ChatGPT, so I went ahead, I did some research, I did some testing, and I ended up with a template that I think works very well for story writing. So today I will show you how you can use this too, so let's just get going. So let's start by looking at the first step we are gonna do in this whole story sequence. So let's take a look at number one here. So this is called author. So we just wanna go, you are a genre author. Your task is to write genre stories in a vivid and intriguing language. Answer with dot 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 if you acknowledge. Don't write anything yet. And we wanna set our genre. So here we set our genre to sci-fi, and that is the first thing we are gonna do. So let's just head over to ChatGPT and paste this in as our prompt. Let's just paste in here, click submit, and hope for that dot dot dot, right? Okay, so now we are good. So let's move on to step number two. So step number two is gonna be our prompt template. So let's just take a look here. So we have title, that is gonna be insert the story title here. We have settings, so insert setting details here, including time period, location, or any relevant background information. Next up, we have the protagonist. So insert the protagonist's name, age, and occupation, as well as a brief description of their personality and motivations. And we have the same for the antagonist. Next up, we have a conflict. So here, insert the main conflict of the story, including the problem the protagonist faces and the stakes involved. We have something about the dialogue, so instructions for using dialogue to advance the plot, to reveal character, and provide information to the reader. Then we move on to theme, so insert a central theme of the story and instructions for developing it throughout the plot, character, and setting. We have also a tone, so we want to set a desired tone for the story, instructions for maintaining consistency and appropriateness to the settings and character. We have a pacing, so we have instructions to vary the pacing to the story to build and release tension, to advance the plot and create dramatic effect. And finally, we have this optional. So here you can insert any additional details or requirements for the story, such as a specific word count or a genre constraint. This specific word count, that's a bit hit and miss. It's very hard to get that right. So yeah, it's not that specific. We're gonna finish this with fill out the template above for a genre story, and then we're gonna set our genre. So in this case, it's gonna be sci-fi. Let's just take this now over to ChatGPT and see what we get back. Then we just head over here, paste in our prompt template. You can see here we end with fill out the template above for a genre story. So the genre is set to sci-fi. Let's just hit enter. Okay, so here we have our template filled out. So let's take a look here. So let's just start. The title is gonna be The Lost Civilization of Sante. Sante, yeah. The year is 2153 and the setting is on a distant planet called Sante. A team of astronauts and scientists have been sent to explore the planet to uncover the mysteries of a long lost civilization. Okay, so we have the protagonist of the story is Dr. Aria Reed, a 32-year-old astroarchaeologist. Aria is smart, driven, and a fiercely independent. She is motivated by her thirst for knowledge and desire to uncover the secrets of the lost civilizations of Sante. So we have the antagonist, that is Captain Throne, the leader of the expedition. Throne is a ruthless, cunning, and ambitious man who will stop at nothing to achieve his goals. Okay, so the conflict. We have the conflict of the story is about the tension between Aria and Throne as they navigate the dangers of Sante to uncover the secrets of the lost civilization. Okay, so the dialogue in the story should be used to advance the plot, reveal character. Yeah, that sounds good. The theme, the central theme of the story is the danger of greed and the consequences of unchecked ambition. The tone of the story should be tense and suspenseful with moments of humor and levity to balance the intensity. Interesting. And the pace of the story should be varied to build and release tension, advance the plot. Yes, sounds very good. So I think we now can just move on to step number three. And step number three is gonna be build story outlines from the factors above. So the factors above is of course gonna be the template we just created. So let's just take this over to ChatGPT and build those outlines. So that was the outline complete. Let's take a closer look here. So we have the introduction. So this is basically what we had right up on the... So we have the protagonist, we have the antagonist, we have the conflict, right? So Atlan number two is gonna be the journey to Shanta. So the team of astronauts and scientists arrive on Shanta and begin their exploration. Ari and Thorne's conflict motivations become clear. Okay, the team encounters the first challenges. So we have chapter or outline number three. So Ari and the team makes a series of breakthrough discoveries. Okay, that's interesting. Thorne's greed and ambition led him to make dangerous decisions. The team of the dangers of greed is developed. Okay, interesting. And the next one we have is the struggle of power. So here we can see Arya and Thorne's conflicts reaches a boiling point. Yeah, this sounds interesting, right? Pacing is used to build and release tension, tense and thrilling action sequences as Arya and Thorne face off. Cool. And we have the conclusion, and here's gonna be Arya and Thorne's final confrontation, the resolution of the conflict, and the outcome of the mission. The story ends on a note of suspense, leaving the reader wondering about the future of Shanta and its lost civilization. And we actually have an epilogue here. It says optional, so that's interesting. And that is the aftermath of the events on Shanta. We have the fate of Arya and Thorne and the rest of the team. And the future of the lost civilization and its secrets. Yeah, I'm happy with this. So I think we now can just move on to step number four. So step number four is gonna be now create story chapters from the outlines above. So let's just copy that, head over to ChatGPT and get those chapters. Okay, so here we have it, our five chapters. We have the epilogue, we have the final confrontation, we have the divide, we have the first discoveries, and we have chapter one, arrival on Shanta. So now let's head over to our last step. And that is gonna be write chapter 1-10 in depth, in great detail, in an intriguing writing style. So let's just copy that, head over to ChatGPT. Go down here and just write chapter. Of course, we want to start with one in depth and in great detail in an intriguing writing style. So that was chapter one done. Let's take a quick look before we move on. Let's just see here. Captain Thrawn's voice crackled through the comms. Welcome to Shanta team. We made it. Dr. Arya Reed looked out the window of the landing shuttle and gasped. The planet was a barren wasteland with jagged rocks and dust storms visible in the distance. But despite its harsh appearance, Arya felt a thrill of excitement run through her. She had spent her entire career studying ancient civilizations, and yeah. Yeah, I think this looks good. So we have some small dialogue, we have some backstory. Yeah, I like this. So this looks quite good. Now I'm just gonna write out every chapter. And then we're gonna take a look at the whole thing and how long it became. And finally, I'm just gonna show you something smart at the end when we have completed our story. Just before we look at the finished story, let me just show you how I do this. Here you can see I write chapter 2, right? So when I wanna write chapter 3, then I just go click here, I change to 3. I just hit save and submit, and then I go on to write number 3, right? Because if you write too long, right, if you don't summarize in between, you're gonna lose some context. We're gonna lose the chapter summarization here, right? So therefore, I like to do it like this. I write one and one chapter just by using this edit button here, and it seems to work fine. So that's just a tip if you're afraid of losing context. So now let's just take a look at the final results. So you can see here we have the lost civilization of Shanta. We have chapter 1, we have chapter 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I read a bit of it and it seemed quite good. It was quite interesting. Kind of wanted to finish it. But let's just count the words here. It's not that long, it's 5 pages. So I guess it's around 2000 words, right? Yeah, it's 1888 words. So 5 pages. For me, that's a good size of stories. If you need more content, you can always expand the chapters, right? So if you add more chapters, then you will get more content. So that is totally up to you. But I think it worked out pretty good and the story was quite interesting. So there was just one thing left I wanted to show you, and that is this. So underneath our chapters here, I want to write an iteration guidance to the story. Let's just hit submit. This is something you can do to improve the story if you wanted to and expand on it. So here we get different suggestions to things we can iterate. So you can see we have character development, we have dialogue, we have setting description, and this can dive deeper into what we want to achieve, right? We have conflict escalation, so gradually escalate the conflict between Arya and Throne, creating a sense of rising tension and drama. We have some team iterations we can do, some tone iteration, using language and pacing to create suspenseful and dramatic, considering using foreshadowing to build anticipation. And we have some optional things here, we'll consider adding an epilogue to the story. Yeah, that's good. So these are some iterations like you can consider during or after the story. So I think that's very useful. It's a bit of what we looked like in the last video. So iteration can be very powerful. So hopefully this gave you some inspiration of how you can write stories in ChatGPT. Also, check out the link in the description to my newsletter. If you sign up there, you will get a PDF with ChatGPT prompts, including the one we used in this video. And you can also find the link to my membership if you want to learn more about generative AI. Also, check out this video here. And as always, thank you for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.